Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a haul. Like, it's going to be like a haul mix of certain things like clothes, shoes, a little bit of makeup, you know, and you know, stuff like that. So if you guys want to see what I have purchased, please keep watching. Just in case you hear my children scream, cry, shout, or by any chance call me, it's my children, so never mind that. My husband's gonna be out there with them in a little bit, so don't worry about that. But I mean, it's something I can't stop because they're my kids and I'm not gonna stop that. But just get right into this. Now, the first thing that I'm going to show you, it's been a while since I've purchased, you know, makeup and stuff. And I've been wanting this product for like, I mean, since the first time I heard about it. And now that I have it, I can't believe it comes in such a small tube for the price. Like, for a drugstore product, I can't believe it. But anyway, it's the L'Oreal Paris The Infallible Pro Matte Foundation, the Demi Matte Finish. Well, obviously the Pro Matte. It's this little guy right here. And overall, my next purchase, it was just something I've been wanting to buy as well. These are mainly, it's just a little bit of makeup that I got, but it's mainly stuff that I've been wanting to buy, and I was finally able to get them. This is the e.l.f. Palette in Need It Nude, and it looks like this. It's so pretty. Like, so pretty. Like, I'm really, like, into, like, you know, like, brown colors and red browns and nudes and stuff like that. Like, real basic neutral colors. That's what I'm really into. And this is actually pretty good. Like, it's pretty good. This palette was, I think, $10, I want to say. And it's pretty good. I like the quality of the shadows. The Maybelline Colossal Big Shot Mascara. I needed mascara so bad because I was using that Salon Perfect. I mean, not the Salon Perfect one. The L'Oreal, what's it called? I forgot what it was called, but I didn't like it at all. Like, at all. And I think it was making my eyelashes fall out, which is a big no-no. Because, I mean, no. I'm not as great to put on, like, fake lashes as it is, even though I like them. But I get sometimes so frustrated by trying to put them on that I'd rather just stick with a really good mascara. And this one is amazing. I mean, it doesn't top out one of my favorites, which is from L'Oreal Telescopic, which is one of my all-time favorites. But this one, like, I mean, it's pretty near it. It's pretty near it. I love it. It's pretty good. My next product is this brow pencil. It's a brow stylist definer. What was that? Brow Stylist Definer by L'Oreal. Ultra Fine Tip Shaping Pencil in Dark Brunette, because my hair is dark. So it comes with a spoolie on one end, as you can see. And it comes with the product in the end. This is actually a pretty good product, but it's already all the way right here. You see how much that is left? And this is like $8. This thing is like $8, which is not bad compared to like Anastasia, Brow Wiz, and all that stuff. But I mean, that's how much it is left, and I've only had this for about a week. Like, come on. It's crazy. My next product is the Maybelline Brow Precise Fiber Volumizer in Medium Brown. It's a brow mascara. And I was surprised at how much I like this. It comes with this little weird looking wand. It literally only has like a brush on one side. It's, you know, you see? And it has like these little fibers on there, which I kind of like, because my eyebrows, they're not that, you know, great on its own. You know, like I have hair and everything, but it's so thin and it's so sparse. Like, it just, this kind of like makes it look like I have a little bit more. Like, it gives a little anyway, cake in it. My next product is this Wet n Wild Photo Focus Vaporize. Wait, what? No. It's the Wet n Wild setting spray. And the only reason why I got this is because my sister told me that it was really good. I was actually wanting to get the new Milani setting spray. And man, it's like, it's been sold off for the longest time. I think they already restocked it. So hopefully I'll be able to get it tomorrow, because I heard that it's incredibly, incredibly good. I mean, from like a whole lot of people. So I really want to get my hands on it. And I mean, for a drugstore price, I mean, you can't beat that. You know what I mean? But this actually, it's pretty good. It sets your makeup in a very beautiful way. It kind of molds everything together and it sinks into your skin and just makes your skin look so flawless. Like, I love it. It's pretty good. It's a pretty good product. I think this was about $5 or so. So it's pretty good. My last makeup product, you know, ish type of thing. No, this is not my last one. I have one more. But this, I got this e.l.f. foundation blurring brush. I wanted to get a brush. I'm going to get more brushes. But when I went to go get e.l.f. brushes, they didn't have any. And I didn't want to be ordering them online because I literally wanted to pick it out by hand because I wanted to feel them and like see the size in person. You know what I mean? Because sometimes online it could be kind of misleading. So I wanted to find a buffer brush that wasn't, you know, pricey. And I found this one, and this is just the e.l.f. brush, like I said, foundation blurring brush. And I like it. I like the way it's so soft to top it off, like really soft. It works really well to buff in your concealer. It works well to buff in your foundation. Like, I haven't used my Real Techniques sponge since I've gotten this, and I've only had this for about a week though, so I don't use makeup consistently every day, especially since I've been sick. I haven't used it, but to top it off, if I sound kind of weird and funny, it's because I'm sick. I'm sorry if I keep looking up, it's because I try to get used to this camera that I'm using. But anyways, so this brush is amazing. Like, it's so soft. The bristles are so soft. The way it's kind of like tapered, like not, it's kind of like tapered, but I don't know. There's just something about it where even like setting it with a powder, it does the job. Like, it does it beautifully, not just, you know, but it does it beautifully. I really, really, really enjoyed this product. I'm hoping to get more, bigger e.l.f. brushes because I have a lot of eye brushes and stuff, but I'm hoping to get more. So my next and last but not least is the Wet n Wild Color Icon bronzer SPF 15, which is this one. This product is called Ticket to Brazil, and to be honest with you, this does not come out on my skin. I have no idea why I got this. I thought this was going to give me, like, just a little bit of color because I don't like to be real dark, you know? Like, I just like a little bit of, like, shade where the sun naturally hits my face. And I don't like to really define those areas. So I thought, like, maybe this will give me, like, a little bit of a tint. But when I put it on, it was like I couldn't see anything. Like, I honestly couldn't see anything. This will probably work well with my sister since she's a lot lighter than I am. So I'll probably pass it on to her. I'm not sure. But I mean, I don't know. Maybe I need to get a darker shade. When I was there was only 2 shades and this was the darkest one. So yeah. I am now going to show you shoes. Now, I'm wearing my shoes right now. I'm wearing a pair of shoes right now. And they're actually just some basic white shoes, which I don't feel like taking them off. So I'll show you guys another time. But my first pair of shoes that I'm going to share you guys is Nike. And I don't think I've ever owned Nike. You know what? I owned Nike a long time ago, like when I was give or take 13, I think. And they stole them. I was in athletics and I put them in my locker. For some reason, I left them there. And because I think it was on my way to theater, because I was also in theater class and a theater club. And they stole them. I don't know why they stole them. I mean, I got a lot of compliments that day because of those shoes, but I have no idea why they were. Seriously, man. I mean, at least the girls from athletics, like, why would they steal them? But anyways, I ended up getting these Nike's Air. I think that's what they're called. Women's Air Max Torch 4. And they're black with silver or black and gray, however you call it. I really need a new pair of tennies to work out in because I can't work out without tennies. And the tennies that I do, that I owned, or that I own still, because I still own them, are Pumas. And I've had them literally, I'm not even joking with you, for about 8 years. have had it for 8 years and they're totally worn out. They don't look like they're worn out. They still look like they're in incredibly good condition, but they're not. They don't feel it. They literally can feel like I'm walking on the floor. But I needed, I couldn't give them up unless I had a new pair of tennis. And these, I mean, it's like you're walking on air. I can't wait till I start working out because I need to. Which I'm pretty excited about because I have never owned a pair before. Obviously, I've owned a lot of boots. These are boots. And there are these. Aren't they so pretty? I don't know. I like them. I like them a lot. I mean, they're a little, I mean, it's a little bit heavy, like a little bit, but nothing I can't handle. But oh my gosh, like I love them so much. I almost like, I don't even want to wear them because I don't want to get them dirty. But of course I'm going to wear them because I already have so many things like in my mind to wear them, like so many styles. These are lugs and these are flirt. They're called flirt. They're women's lugs, of course. And I love them. I just love how they have this little, like, they have that lift, you know, for a woman's foot. And I love, like, it has, like, a, this little heel. Like, it's not, it's more, a little bit thicker than its normal size. And I don't know, it just looks, it looks more feminine but real tomboyish at the same time, you know. I don't know, I'm really, like, I'm digging. I've always liked boots like this, you know, but more feminine-y type of boot. I have some other Skechers, and they're, like, they're brown, and I've worn them. You know, I've worn them a lot, and I love them too. They're a little bit big for me, though, but I wore them too, and they're just more flat. They're more like, you know, flat. But I've been wanting these for such a long time, and finally I've had some, and it's like literally my first pair of lugs. My next shoe is this. It's just, it's a sandal, and it's so pretty, right? I wanted a black, I have so many black shoes, like I'm not even joking. Like I have black wedges and several black heels and black boots and booties. And I need to get rid of my black boots and I need to get another pair of black boots because my black, the black boots I have right now are totally, they're also really old where they hurt like to walk now because everything from inside has already like worn down. I need to give up already. I already had them for so many years. And I know, I kind of wear my shoes until they totally fully give out on me. Like, I'm just, yeah, and if I could save them, I will. Like, I'm totally weird that way. But these are just black pair of sandals with a little bit of a, what do you call it? Heel, but it's like a block heel. It's like a block heel. Looks like this on this side. It's real pretty, casual. I needed something real basic and casual that will go to a lot of, that will, look good with a lot of things, almost like in a daily cuteness, like whenever I wanted to just put them on and not have trouble when I need to chase after my children or anything like that. So these are, I like them, they're really cute. I need to break them in though because I really need to break these in just from right here mainly, but they're really cute. I love them. I my got next these one at Target. It's just a real basic sandal that I got from Wally's. And they're just these. They look kind of like, I don't know. These are just my everyday sandals because I'm tired of wearing my Crocs. So these are just my everyday sandals. They're just beige and I wanted them to just be very versatile. So yeah, this is what I got. I'm just gonna show them to you. This first purchase is from Target. Most of these are actually from Target and from Melrose, I think. Yeah, Melrose. And my first purchase is this dress. As you can see, it's like a navy blue. It's not black. I think it's showing up like black on the camera. If it is, I'm sorry. But it's navy blue. It's so pretty. It has like this mesh right here on the top on the sleeve and all across the top. And it has like these, this pattern of like little flowers right here. It's so cute. And then the bottom of it is just like real flowy. It's like double layered and it's real flowy. And the back just has that, like, you know, that one button right there. It's very cute. I love it. And these are just some camel pants. I really like camel. I remember I owned a pair of camel pants when I was in high school. Just a little bit more baggier. And I loved them and I wore them out until I couldn't wear them anymore. And I think I made them into a skirt to top it off because I was always real experimentative with my clothing. So these are just some regular camel pants and it kind of like a bootlegged type of thing. It's not like a, it's not a flare or anything like that. I've already worn these like several times. So hence why you don't see it like all hanging up and stuff. Yeah, it's like this dress that's real like, I don't know what you call this. It's real like cringed up here on top where it kind of like snugs on you. And then this real flowy right here in the bottom. It's like above the knee. And it has like the what do you call it? The bell sleeves, which is the in thing right now. It's actually pretty hot where I live. Like, it's real hot. But the sleeves are so thin. Like, they're basically see-through, the sleeves. It's so thin. But right here, it covers you well, which is what I like. And it's kind of like an off-the-shoulder type of thing, which is also the in thing. And how it's going to be summer soon, spring, summer. It's always hot down here, regardless what it is, what weather, what season it is. I think it'll look real cute. So, yeah. Next, I have this other dress, and it's basically the same thing as the other one, except it's not long sleeve. It's actually off the shoulder as well. Well, you can use it both ways, and it's actually like real tight from here. Not tight, but it's real like knitted together, and then it has it's a little bit longer. This goes past your knees, but not. It's almost like a little bit past your knees, not dramatically. It's real cute, the real summery and spring type of. I also got this at Target, and it's like a rustic type of orange, and it's actually also like a short. It's like a 3/4 length sleeve, but it like a bell sleeve, and it has like this off the shoulder but gap thing right here. It just has like these two slits in the center. Like of design, and it's like real loose, like it flows from the bottom. You can see that it's real flowy. It actually, it's really really flowy. It's a very flowy type of dress, very very cute, very relaxed and chilled, real thin, but very cute and basic. I wanted something that was real basic, but if I needed to top off, like top something on myself and just head out the door for something, you know, serious, you know, like church meeting or something, or something for the school, like whenever I have a meeting for the school or anything like that. I wanted to really get something like that. It's cute. I actually was going to pair this with another, with a skirt that I have on with it. The front part is actually a lot longer. It's like a knitted, and the bottom is just like a kind of like a, almost like a crop top, but it's not a crop top, and it's just like knitted, and then it's a lot longer in the front than it is in the back. The colors are like almost like a deep, it's almost like a red maroon with black, and it's like an off white, you know. And it comes with this jewel, this necklace that's attached to it. It's very cute. My next one is this jean vest. I've been searching for a jean vest for the longest time. I had a jean vest I was so in love with, but they stole it when they broke into my apartment a few years ago. And I was so like mad because they stole a lot of my clothes, and a lot of my pieces were like pieces that took me a while to get. And they're kind of those pieces that don't ever they never go out of style. And one of them was my jean vest. And it was like a blue that was so deep and, you know, like a rich blue. But it was just one of those things that just don't go out of style. And it was actually real thick. It was actually a thick jean as well. And I don't know. I loved it. So I just ended up finding this jean vest. And I love it. It's not similar to the one that I had, because this is a lot, you know, darker, and it has like fade here in the center, but I mean it'll do for a lot of things that I want to do with it. I feel like a vest, especially a jean vest, can go with so many things. You can create so many styles with this, so many pieces put together with this, because it can go, you know, with jeans, it can go with skirts, it can go with dresses, you can mix it up with different type of tops, you know. And I don't know, I feel like you can create a lot of good looks with this. It's a very basic white top. It flows white, very breathable because how it's so hot down here, and it kind of fringes right here in the top, you know. It could be off the shoulders or on the shoulders, But overall, it's real cute. It has like these very cute patterns. And the color is not white, but it's almost like pearl white or something, like pearlish color. It's very pretty. You can style it with a lot of things. And it just, it's a blouse, and it's kind of like a silky chevron. I don't know if it's silky or chevron type of blouse. It's real nice. And it looks a lot more professional looking compared to my other blouses. But, I mean, I like different type of looks, so. But it has a zipper in the center, which I love. I love that. And it has like these little pockets. It's very, very cute. And it flows in the center as well. And for some reason, I'm really into this color. Like, my favorite color is blue. But I'm starting to really like this color as well. It's kind of like a mix of blue and green. Not aqua, but, you know, in between. I don't know. It's very nice. I feel like I've been wanting one of these shirts for the longest time, but I've always doubted myself in purchasing because I know myself. And because I feel like I've always told myself I wouldn't wear it because every time I would try one on, it was always real thick. And then I went to Target and I was asking my husband, you know, should I get this? And he was like, well, you know what? Try it on. So I tried it on and everything. I looked at myself in the mirror. I was like, man, I like it. And it was like, it's super thin. Look how thin it is. It's insane. So I wanted one because specifically with these type of blouses, with these type of blouses, I feel like they can go with anything. I mean, I wouldn't wear this by, I would wear it by itself if it was in the winter. But like during the summer months or even spring, I like to wear this as a topper. Like I like to top this off with maxi dresses mainly, or with blouses that just need a little bit of, you know, a little bit of a kick, you know, a little bit of something to give it that extra mile, you know, and I feel like this will do it. And I mean, I don't know, I love it. I really like the jean look. I don't know, like the jean, you know, the jean piece. And it's like a spaghetti strap, but with an off the shoulder, except it has like these wide sleeves right here. I think you also call these bell sleeves. I'm not entirely sure. Real flowy. This color is almost like on the purple side, like purplish with a little bit of a gray undertone, you know? And it has like this design right here, which I think is very cute. Real like knitted. Very summer, very spring. And it could be off the shoulder, which I think it looks a lot better off the shoulder than it does on the shoulder. Just gives it that extra something. I don't know. I was a little bit iffy when I tried it on because of this right here. Like just the ruffle type, it reminded me of something when I used to wear when I was a kid. But I thought it was so cute. I imagine myself wearing like with some type of Western boot with this, or even if I wanted to make it more casual, I can pair it up with a pair of black sandals that I have, or maybe like a pair of you know, rustic brown sandals, which I'm also in the search for. And I thought it would be so cute. This is actually something that is kind of like coming back, and I don't know, I love it. In the bottom, it's kind of like stress, de-stress and stuff, and this top too, I love it. It's just a very thin top. It's long, it actually goes way past your waist, and it covers your bottom if you want it to. And it comes with like a ruffle sleeve, which I really like because it gives that extra, you know, like little girl, like not little girl, little girly, you know, little girliness to you. Sophisticated but girly, you know, something like that. And I thought it's real cute. It has this little opening right here, which it doesn't show anything drastic or anything like that, as well as the back has a little button right here. And it's very cute, very breathable, especially when if you live in an area where it's really hot, it's real breathable. So I love it. Okay, my next piece is this jacket, and it's a bomber jacket. I think that's what they're called. I also got this at Target, and it's real floral. It's black, and it has like this detailed of like a stripe type of thing right here. And it has like this black and white collar with a black and white sleeve. And I like it. Like I wore this already once, but it started raining that day. And man, I love it. It's not hot to wear because it's kind of like a silky, not silky, it's just a real thin layer. Almost kind of like silky. No, not silky. I don't know how to describe this type of material. But it's actually very, very comfortable. And I loved it. I've been wanting one of these for the longest time. It's actually pretty good. Here's a pair of black pants. Just, you know, nothing out of the ordinary. Just some black skinny pants that I wanted to wear with some blouses. I don't have a pair of just regular black jeans. So, and they're like these major bell bottoms. Look how huge they are. And it has like this, what do you call it? This distress part right here. Which kind of making me think, you know, like, really? It's kind of funny, to be honest with you. It's like they did this on purpose and then like that. Oh, that's interesting. Anyway, that's the way it is. Of course, that's the way they had it. But it's just a regular pair of jeans. And the top part is just, you know, like that. And it's like a little bit light from right here in the center. I like it. I can't really imagine wearing like my bomber jacket with this.
Hi guys, I'm recording from my phone now because my camera just died. But besides that, I wanted to show you my camera, hence why I'm also recording from my phone. Okay, so I got this phone, this camera, because I've been wanting to record with a camera already and not use my phone all the time. Mainly because of storage space and because I just really wanted to start using a camera. I already had a camera, Canon, but I didn't like the image quality on it, and my husband said that for me just to return it and he'll get me another camera. And so he got me this camera. It's a Nikon. So let me show you guys right now. Hold on. Excuse me, I'm a little bit sick. He got me this camera and it's a Nikon. It just turned off on me right now because the battery died, so I need to charge the battery, so I won't be able to open it up for you guys. But this is a camera that I just used right now to record this video. And it's a point shoot camera. I'm not sure. But I mean, as long as I can still record with it for a good amount of time, I'm good with that. And one of the main things I loved about this camera is that you can flip the screen upside. That way I can see myself that I'm in the picture. Because I have such a problem when I was using my phone that even though I would use the rear end of the rear camera, I wouldn't be, you know, in focus. I wouldn't be like, you know, sometimes in the picture, and that would frustrate me a great deal. And I would try so hard to put myself in focus, and it was just so frustrating. Like, I got so frustrated, I didn't even bother to try anymore. I just kept on using the front facing camera. So finally that I'm using this camera, I'm able to use this and you know, practice with it and work with it. I do sometimes pay attention to that rather than the lens. Looking at it, which I do catch myself doing a lot, which I'm also working on that, so I hope you guys can just bear with me on that because I am learning. But overall, I really do enjoy this camera. I like for vlogging as well because I do like to vlog a lot. So this is the camera that my husband got me. I would have preferred it in black because I don't know, I feel black is a lot more discreet, but I love it. Overall, I love it a lot. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Forgive me if you guys hear my children in the background and everything, but I mean, they're home, so there's really not much I can do about it. I don't have a lot of time during the day when they're in school. And I'm sorry, I'm a little bit under the weather. I'm just not feeling like... I mean, I don't mind recording. I enjoy it. I'm so nasally, so I'm having trouble kind of like getting words out and everything. So I'm sorry about that. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys enjoyed the clothes that I purchased and the little things that I purchased. I've been wanting new things for such a quite some time, and it does take a while for me to get stuff like that, so we always have other priorities first and stuff, blah 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 blah. But anyways, I'm actually very excited to try a lot of these purchases. I actually had one more purchase to show you guys. This that I'm wearing is a t-shirt dress, and I got it from Target as well. And it goes above my knee. It's gray. It's very simple, just basic. It looks just like a long t-shirt, and I love it. It's insanely comfortable, like insanely comfortable. One of my best buys ever. But anyways, I'm really excited to wear my other stuff and see what I could do with it, see what I could work with it, because I love purchasing items that I know I can wear consistently and with other things rather than just for the season, you know. So I'm really more about how much use I can get out of it. So anyway, thank you guys for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video, please give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in my next one. God bless you guys.